Hi, welcome to Math 2C Lectures, and this is Bandi. Today we'll be talking about set theory, which is one of the most foundational theory in mathematics, and many other theories like theory of probability, measure theory are based on set theory. So just introducing sets, a set is simply a collection of objects, simply a collection of similar objects or objects with some similar property. Okay, the objects are called members of the set. And a set is named by, is named somehow, depending on the property that the elements have. So just to define what it is, a set is a collection of objects, and the members of the set are just called the members or the elements of the set. Let's look at some examples. So suppose we have a set A, which is named with the capital letter A, and usually that's how sets are named, with capital letters A's. And with some members, say A, B, C, and D. Usually members are with small letters, so that's how we have this set. So we have a set capital A with members small a, small b, small c, and small d. And the way a set is written is as follows. This is just to develop the notation of writing a set. So a set A can be written as the in curly brackets A, B, C, and D. All right, and remember that in sets the order does not matter. So what does mean is that this is same as A, C, B, D, and E. All right, so the order does not matter when you define a set. So set is just a collection. It's not an ordered collection, but it's just a collection of objects. All right, proceeding further, let's look at how sets can be represented and special types of sets. So to be mathematically rigorous, people also defined a set called an empty set. An empty set is something, you guessed it right, it doesn't have any elements in it, and it's represented by the symbol phi. Okay, and this is how an empty set is represented. In many proofs, when you look at many mathematically rigorous proofs, we will be using the set phi because it comes up a lot of times, just like the number 0, which doesn't mean a lot, but it keeps coming up a lot in mathematically rigorous proofs. All right, now how can sets be represented, right? So one way to represent sets is through the process of enumeration, where it's just, you just define the set by just enumerating all its elements. And this is mostly feasible if your set is finite, right? So if your set has, say, 10 elements, then you can actually enumerate all the elements of the set. For example, if your set is just the set of even numbers less than 10, then the elements are just 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10, right? So this set of objects, set of numbers, set of even numbers, such that each of them is less than or equal to 10. Okay, now since we only have 5 natural numbers that are even as well as less than 10, we can just represent this set by this following notation. So what I mean is, you can just enumerate each of these elements. All right, and this is not very scalable because in practice you will be dealing with a lot of sets of points, sets of objects having some property, say set of all Indian people, set of all Chinese people. So you cannot enumerate all of them, right? So you just, there is another notation